23, skidoo, hut, hut. Here.
Smithers, I'm home.
What? Already?
Yes.
Is it my imagination or is TV getting worse?
Well, it's about the same. Oh, look out, Smithers! I love this show.
Hello, my name is Mr. Snrub, and I come from someplace far away. Yes, that'll do. Anyway, I say we invest that money back in the nuclear plant.
I like the way Snrub thinks.
I'll keep it short and sweet. Family, religion, friendship. These are the three demons you must slay if you wish to succeed in business. When opportunity knocks, you don't want to be driving to the maternity hospital or sitting in some phony baloney church. Or synagogue. Questions?
Which do you think is more important, hard work or stick-to-itiveness?
Are there any real questions?
Someone is charging room service to the company, sir.
Slay! Oh, what was I laughing at now? Oh, yes, that crippled Irishman. Who is that bookworm, Smithers?
Homer Simpson, sir.
Simpson, eh? How very strange. His job description clearly specifies an illiterate.
Homer Simpson, sir. One of your organ banks from Sector 7G. All the recent events of your life have revolved around him in some way.
Simpson, eh? Wait a minute. Go back. Zoom in. Why is that man in pink?
Oh, that's Homer Simpson, sir. He's one of your boobs from Sector 7G.
Simpson, eh? Well, judging by his outlandish attire, he's some sort of free-thinking anarchist. 7G? Good God, who's the safety inspector there?
Homer Simpson, sir.
Simpson, eh? Good man, intelligent. Who is that firebrand, Smithers?
That's Homer Simpson, sir.
Simpson, eh? New man?
Actually, sir, he thwarted your campaign for governor. You ran over his son. He saved the plant from meltdown. His wife painted you in the nude.
Doesn't ring a bell. That's right. Gather the nectar, my little drones, and make the honey. Honey for your children. Fools!
Ready for that drink, sir?
Just a second, Smithers. Let me introduce you to the gang. That's Buzz. That's Honey. And you see that queen over there? Her name is Smithers.
That's very flattering, sir, but we should go. Several bees are stinging me.
Whoop-de-doo, Mr. Florist. Whoop-de-doo, Mr. Physical Trainer. Whoop-de-doo, Mr. President.
I'm happy you finally found love.
Whoop-de-doo, Tarantula Town. Whoop-de-doo, employees. Everyone who's found true love may leave early today.
Yeah! All right.
Far too much dancing. Not nearly enough prancing.
A little mincing would be nice.
Yes?
Hello.
May I help you?
Could you give me a little push in the opposite direction?
Okay.
Thank you.
Sir, the actors are here to audition for the part of you.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Next.
Excellent.
Next.
Exactly.
So!
Next.
Excelente! Es muy bueno.
Oh, it's hopeless. I'll have to play myself. Right here.
patriotism.
Self-indulgent tripe.
I don't care what they say. I'm going to win this festival.
You truly are the king of kings.
Excellent. Smithers, are they booing me?
No, they're saying boo-erns. Boo-erns.
Are you saying boo or boo-erns?
Boo! I was saying boo-erns.
Now, what are the two E's? Enunciate and energy.
Well, I have nothing to offer you but my love.
I specifically said no geeks.
But my mom says I'm cool.
Next.
Give me your fortune or I'll pound your withered old face in.
Ooh, I like his energy. Put him on the callback list.
Clang, clang, clang with the trolley. Ring, ring, ring with the bell. Zing, zing, zing with my heartstring.
Thank you. Give the bully an extra point.
I propose to you that your heir need not be a boy. In this phallocentric society of ours...
I don't know what phallocentric means, but no girls!
So much for Plan B.
Ray Burns. A life.
If you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours.
Wait a minute. Is he coming on to me?
I mean, if I should slip something into your pocket, what's the harm?
My God, he is coming on to me.
After all, negotiations make strange bedfellows.
Sorry, Mr. Burns, but I don't go in for these backdoor shenanigans. Sure, I'm flattered, maybe even a little curious, but the answer is no.
I've called you all here because I need some honest answers. What is my current financial situation?
Great.
Great.
I hear great.
All right, well, let's have a look at my stock portfolio. Confederated slave holdings, how's that doing?
It's, steady.
I'm sure all your stocks are doing well, sir. After all, you chose them.
Well, let's get out the old stock ticker and have a look. Here's where I stopped checking it last time. September 1929. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Smithers, why didn't you tell me about this market crash?
Well, sir, it happened 25 years before I was born.
Oh, that's your excuse for everything.
Out those pockets! Atoms! 1, 2, 3, 4... 6 of them! Take him away!
You can't treat the working man this way! One day we'll form a union and get the fair and equitable treatment we deserve. Then we'll go too far and get corrupt and shiftless. And the Japanese will eat us alive!
The Japanese?! Those sandal-wearing goldfish tenders? Bosh! Flimshaw!
If only we had listened to that boy instead of walling him up in the abandoned coke oven.
I bring you love.
Is that the love between a man and a woman, or the love of a man for a fine Cuban cigar?
I bring you love.
It's bringing love. Don't let it get away.
Break its legs.
Wait! You want an alien? This is your alien.
Hello, children. I bring you love.
It's a monster. Kill it. Kill it.
It's not a monster. It's Mr. Burns.
Oh, it's Mr. Burns.
Kill it. Kill it.
Now let me explain. Every Friday evening after work, Mr. Burns undergoes a series of medical treatments designed to cheat death for another week. First, Mr. Burns' chiropractors perform a slight spinal adjustment. Then a team of doctors administers eye drops, painkillers, and a vocal cord scraping.
Don't worry, you won't feel a thing till I jam this down your throat.
The whole ordeal leaves Mr. Burns twisted and disoriented.
The most rewarding part was when he gave me my money.
But what's with the glowing?
I'll field that question. A lifetime of working in a nuclear power plant has given me a healthy green glow. Left me as impotent as a Nevada boxing commissioner. And now that I'm back to normal, I don't bring you peace and love. I bring you fear, famine, pestilence, and...
I'm for a booster!
Good morning, starshine. The Earth says hello.
You twinkle above us. We twinkle below.
Good morning, starshine.
The social security number, not, not, not. Not, 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 too. Damn, Roosevelt. Cause of parents' death? Got in my way. Now, Doctor, I want you to test me for everything. Every disease on this chart.
Fine. We'll just start by drawing some blood. Well, isn't that odd? It's like poking through meringue.
No, try this arm. I saw some blood in there the other day.
Come on, keep blowing. Okay, 12 centimeters. Excellent.
I'm a big boy.
There's your problem.
Well, Doc, I think I did pretty well in my tests. You may shake my hand if you like.
Well, under the circumstances, I'd rather not.
Eh?
Mr. Burns, I'm afraid you are the sickest man in the United States. You have everything.
You mean I have pneumonia?
Yes.
Juvenile diabetes?
Yes.
Hysterical pregnancy?
A little bit, yes. You also have several diseases that have just been discovered in you.
I see. You're sure you just haven't made thousands of mistakes?
No, I'm afraid not.
Well, this sounds like bad news.
Well, you'd think so, but all of your diseases are in perfect balance. If you have a moment, I can explain.
Well...
Here's the door to your body, you see? And these are oversized novelty germs. That's influenza, that's bronchitis, and this cute little cuddle bug is pancreatic cancer. Here's what happens when they all try to get through the door at once. Move it, shout ahead. We call it Three Stooges syndrome.
So what you're saying is... I'm indestructible.
Oh, no. In fact, even a slight breeze could...
Indestructible. Not a single microbe can get in or out. Who the devil are you?
Don't panic. Just come up with a good story. My name is Mr. Burns.
Don't... Hey, Burnsy! This was some swell shindig. Thank you very much.
Smithers, what's happening?
I had a great time. I just want to shake your hand.
Smithers, help!
Doesn't seem as funny to me, but what do I know?
Smithers!
Oh, my God.
Mattingly, get rid of those sideburns.
What sideburns?
You heard me, hippie. Mattingly, for the last time, get rid of those sideburns.
Look, Mr. Burns, I don't know what you think sideburns are, but...
Don't argue with me! Just get rid of them! Mattingly! I thought I told you to trim those sideburns! Go home! You're off the team!
It's the boogeyman's grandfather!
He's gonna drink our bones!
Smile! Like this! Ooh, that one. No, he's a bit listless, isn't he? Give me... Ooh, that spirited fellow. Ooh. He didn't put up much of a fight. Why don't you pick one for me? On second thought, I'll just have a glass of milk. From that cow. You stay with me. You're the pick of the litter. Vest, see my vest, made from real gorilla chest. Feel this sweater, there's no better than authentic Irish setter. See this hat, it was my cat, my evening wear, vampire bat. These white slippers are albino, African endangered rhino, grizzly bear underwear, turtles necks, I've got my share. Beret of poodle on my noodle, it shall rear. Ketchup. 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 Kids. he's more clever than he looks.
Abraham Simpson, your family is here to visit you.
Hot diggity, my family's come to visit me! Wait a minute! My family never comes to visit.
Don't! Not again!
I can't take much more of your blundering numbskullery.
I'll be in the car, dudes.
There is one more way to kill a man, but it is as intricate and precise as a well-played game of chess.
Was that me or was that you?
Okay, we'll do something about that right away. Let's start by doubling your medication. Our residents are trying to nap!
Me and my fourth form chums think it would be quite corking if you'd sign over your oil well to the local energy concern.
Mr. Burns, it was naive of you to think I would mistake this town's most prominent 104-year-old man for one of my elementary school students.
I want that oil well. Smithers, what's the meaning of this slacking off?
There's a bee in my eye, sir.
And?
I'm allergic to bee stings. They cause me to, die.
But we're running out of forward momentum.
Perhaps you could pedal for just a little while, sir.
Quite impossible. I can try to bat him off if you like.
Really, that's okay.
Holy cats, man, we're starting to wobble.
Get me to a hospital. You have to pedal.
No, Tuttle Sunday trousers. Fear not, I'll get you to a hospital. The only way I know how. Smithers, you infernal ninny, stick your left hoof on that flange now! Now, if you can get it through your bug-addled brain, jam that second mephitic clodhopper of yours on the right doodad! Now pump those scrawny chicken legs, you stuporous funker! One more jostle, you wretched shirkaday! Die!
Oh, help me.
Holy smokes! You'll need booze!